Welcome everyone to this live edition of UC Sports. I'm Brandon Martinez, alongside Kyle Barry, and we have updates for you on all UConn sports, including the road trips taken by the men and women's soccer teams, and we have an exclusive first look at the brand new UC Sports documentary on UConn's club lacrosse team.
We will be bringing you all that and more, but we begin tonight with UConn football, who had their homecoming game this past weekend against the UCF Knights.
That's right, Kyle. The Huskies were looking to write another chapter in the storied rivalry of the conflict. Homecoming game for UConn, taking on UCF, that conflict trophy is on the line, and UConn has won the last two matchups. Second quarter now, and Arkell Newsom tumbles his way into the end zone. UConn would lead as much as 13 in this one, but late in the first half, Dedrick Snelson catches a 22-yard touchdown pass, and then right before halftime, Jordan Atkins puts the Knights within two of the Huskies. Coach Bob Diaco was displeased with giving the Knights a chance to score before halftime.
You know, the one piece is you can't give up points in the final 2 minutes of a half. That was a big deal. That was a big moment.
Huskies did not score again in the second half while UCF continued to stay hot. Huskies dropped the conflict 24-16, your final from homecoming.
The American Athletic Conference took their preseason polls this past week, with UConn men's basketball picked to finish second in the conference this season, edged out by the Cincinnati Bearcats by one vote. The Huskies received 5 first-place votes, while Cincy received 6. Last season, UConn won the AAC tournament and advanced to the second round of the NCAA tournament, losing to top seed Kansas. They will be breaking in a consensus top 10 recruiting class, headlined by Al-Tariq Gilbert, who is the 12th McDonald's All-American to join the UConn program, and the AAC Preseason Rookie of the Year. He will be joined by Juwan Durham, Vince Jackson, Mamadou Diarra, and Christian Vital. Head coach Kevin Ollie will blend that youth with several veterans, including 2014-15 American Defensive Player of the Year Amita Brima, Rodney Purvis, and last year's American Preseason Rookie of the Year, Jalen Adams.
When we return, UConn soccer hit the road, while women's basketball is the unanimous choice to win their conference. And we still have that exclusive first look at UC Sports Club's lacrosse documentary. All that and more on this live edition of UC Sports.
So, Cindy, what are we doing today here?
We're skydiving onto the Great Lawn at UConn on spring weekend.
And are you excited?
I'm so excited.
Nervous?
I'm a little nervous, yeah.
Welcome back to UC Sports. The men's soccer team traveled down to Orlando last Saturday, taking on the UCF Knights. After their stunning victory over Boston College, the Huskies were looking to ride that wave of momentum into their matchup with the Knights. It was all for naught, however, as the Huskies dropped a heartbreaker 2-1 in overtime. Adu Bakayjam scored the lone goal for the Huskies, while the Knights scored their 2 goals on just 9 shots.
UConn women's soccer traveled to Temple and left the Owls fans disappointed as the Huskies notched their 14th win of the year, 1-0. Stephanie Ribeiro scored the lone goal of the game, while Emily Armstrong recorded her 9th shutout of the year. UConn has now won 4 straight, but has not lost a match since September 8th. They'll close out their season with 2 more road games before the conference tournament begins on November 2nd.
UConn field hockey does a lot of winning, but as the old saying goes, you can't win them all. The team dropped their first game of the season to Maryland 2-1. This is the first loss since last year's national semifinals game versus Syracuse, and their first regular season loss in 43 games, snapping their 42 regular season game winning streak. The Huskies did come away with a share of the regular season Big East title and will conclude their season this weekend before the Big East tournament begins on November 4th.
The Ice Bus was in Hartford this past week, taking on American International. First period, Huskies strike first. Evan Richardson scores from straight on. But just 9 minutes later, Jared Pike swings around the net and ties things up for the Yellow Jackets with his first goal of the year. Now with less than a minute left in the first, great passing by Richardson and Max Coulter leads to a Carl Elmire goal, his third of the season. Second period, Huskies looking to preserve their lead, but Sean McBride sneaks one past the Huskies goalie, and UConn plays to its third tie of the season, 2-2, your final score. When we return, UConn women's basketball is the unanimous choice to win the AAC as the Lady Huskies look for a 5th straight national championship. And you'll get a special look at UC Sports' brand new documentary on the men's club lacrosse team. Stay tuned, you're watching UC Sports.
Watching right now, and that's okay, but we'll be here when you get around to it.
Still here. So I'm still getting paid for this, right?
No.
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 All right.
Welcome back to UC Sports. Football is traveling down to East Carolina this weekend to take on the Pirates, while women's soccer closes out its regular season on the road against Cincinnati and ECU. Finally, field hockey is home against Quinnipiac on Friday, and then concludes its regular season on the road against Boston College.
UConn's women's basketball has been picked unanimously to win the American this upcoming season. The Huskies have 4 straight national championships and have never lost a game in American Athletic Conference play. Without Breonna Stewart, Morgan Tuck, and Mariah Jefferson, this team will be led by Kia Nurse, who was picked as the preseason AAC Player of the Year and made the 2017 Nancy Lieberman Award watch list for top collegiate point guard. Nurse was also selected to the preseason AAC All-Conference First Team. Nurse is joined by sophomore Katie Lou Samuelson on the All-Conference First Team, while sophomore Nafisa Collier and junior Gabby Williams made the preseason All-Conference Second Team. The team is currently on a 75-game winning streak. The record, of course, was set back in 2010 at 90 straight victories by, guess who? UConn. If UConn wins its first 14 games, the Huskies will have a chance to tie the record on January 4th against ECU at the Excel Center. Win number 91 would be on January 10th, also at the Excel Center, against USF.
UConn's club lacrosse team is about to embark on another season here in Storrs, Connecticut, and UC Sports will be following all the action this season with a brand new documentary. Here's a special look at UC Sports' newest program.
Thank you.
That looks like it's going to be a pretty good perspective on that team.
No, that's something you're definitely not going to want to miss. But that's it for this edition of UC Sports. Make sure you go to our YouTube channel at UCTV Channel 14 and subscribe. You can also follow us on Twitter at UCTV Sports for live game updates and the latest news on all things UConn sports. I'm Brandon Martinez.
And I'm Kyle Berry. We'll see you guys same time next week. Good night.